إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My subject tonight is about enjoining good and forbidding evil. Al-amr bil-ma'ruf والنهي عن المنكر. Maybe a lot of Muslims these days feel inferior. They feel down. Some of our youth these days, they don't want to be identified as Muslims. They hide. If his name is Muhammad, when he is asked about his name, he says, Mu. He doesn't want to show his Islam. A lot of our women, they took off their hijab because the hijab attributed them to Islam. Subhanallah. If they just know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them in his revelation, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. Dear Muslims, Allah سبحانه وتعالى is praising you in the Quran. He's saying, you are the best ummah ever raised for mankind because you enjoy the good and you forbid the evil and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For you to understand the spirit of this verse, you see, before the sending of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to mankind, look at the pattern before him. Always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a messenger to remind people of Tawheed, of La ilaha illallah. And then after a while, the people go astray. Then what happens? Allah would send another messenger, another prophet, to call people again back to Tawheed, to Islam. And then after this messenger dies, the people follow his footsteps for a while, and then gradually the message dies. The people gradually go away from Tawheed, go away from Islam to shirk and wickedness. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends another messenger. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran uses the verb ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَا. Then we resurrected from the dead nation a man who's alive with Tawheed in his heart, and he called the people back to Islam. You see, once it came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, Allah labeled him to be the seal. No more messengers, no more prophets. That is why anyone who comes after Muhammad and claims that he's a messenger, all you have to do is just do like this and walk away. You're a wako, get alive. The fact that your messenger is labeled to be the seal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us the responsibility of doing the work of the messengers until the day of resurrection. كما في حديث معاوية ابن أبي سفيان رضي الله عنه المخرج في الصحيح، النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says: لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق. There will be always a group of my follower on the truth. You know who are those groups? These brothers who are teaching these young men the aqeedah, the correct aqeedah, al-asma wa-sifat, al-tawheed al-rububiyya wa al-tawheed al-uluhiyya. Hada wal-fariq. The followers of the aqeedah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the sahaba and the righteous predecessors, our righteous predecessors. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في حديث أخرجه الإمام الترمذي وأحمد من حديث بهز بن حكيم عن أبيه عن جده، وجده ومعاوية بن حيدة رضي الله عنه وله صحبة، قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says: أنتم توفون 70 أمة. Our number, once it comes to the nations before us, we are number 70. There are 70 nations who existed before us. There are 69 nations who existed before us. We are the number 70. أنتم توفون 70 أمة. أنتم خيرها وأكرمها على الله. You are the best of them in the sight of Allah. So why do you shy away from Islam? Why do you shy away from being a Muslim? Come on. It doesn't matter who you are in the sight of evil. It matters who you are in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I want to call upon my brothers and sisters in Islam and remind them with the statement of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anh commenting about this verse. Yes, it is the best ummah. because of their tongue, not because of their birth, not because of their countries. No. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu says, من أراد أن يكون من خير أمة فليؤدي الشر. If you want to be from that best ummah, you must fulfill the conditions. What are the conditions? كن خير أمة أخرجت للناس. Why? You are the best ummah ever brought to mankind. Why? وتأمرون بالمعروف. You enjoy المعروف. وأعلى المعروف هو التوحيد. And the highest of المعروف أنك تدعو الناس إلى التوحيد. تدعوهم إلى لا إله إلا الله. You call mankind to believe in the oneness of Allah. That Allah is one. He has no father. He has no son. هو أحد في ذاته، أحد في أفعاله، أحد في أسمائه، أحد في صفاته، لا ند له، لا شبيه له، لا مثيل له سبحانه وتعالى. No one is similar to Allah سبحانه وتعالى once it comes to his divine essence, in fact. No one knows the greatness of the essence of Allah but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one is like him. No one is similar to him once it comes to his actions. أفعال الربوبية, the actions of lordship. الخلق والملك والتصريف أو التدبير. The actions of creation, control, and disposing the affairs of his creations. No one is like him. No one is similar to him once it comes to his names and attributes. We're calling people to this. This is the highest of the calling that a person can do. At-Tawheed. ونأمر تأمرون بالمعروف وننهى عن المنكر. Number two, وتنهون عن المنكر. And the highest level of evil is shirk. Shirk. We say this is shirk. If you attribute any of the actions of Allah to a human being, we say this is shirk. If you say that Wali knows the unseen, shirk. If you go around the graves asking the dead, this is shirk. If you say Jesus is God, this is shirk. If you say Jesus is divine, this is shirk. We say no. If you say Allah has a son, this is shirk. ننهى عن المنكر. If you tell me this Wali, this Shaykh Tariqa knows the unseen, this is shirk. If you believe that there is someone who can give you life and takes it away, this is shirk. If you believe that there is someone who can benefit you and harm you, I tell you this is shirk. If you follow other ways than the way of the messenger, I tell you this is bid'ah. And so on. نهي عن المنكر. وتؤمنون بالله. And you believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. يا إخوة في نقطة في هذه الآية عجيبة. There is a very interesting piece in this verse that you cannot get it from by pondering upon it. Look. تأمرون بالمعروف. وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. أهم شيء, the most important thing in those three is what? Is the third one, الإيمان بالله. and يحقق المؤمن الإيمان. The most important of the three is the third one. لماذا تأخرت في الآية? Why was it delayed in the verse? Why it was preceded with enjoining good and forbidding evil? Why the iman billah, believe in Allah, was delayed in the verse? Why it was number three and not number one? In spite of the fact, this is the most important of the three. لأن الإيمان بالله لا يستقيم إن لم تأمر بمعروف وتنهى عن You cannot attain it. As if enjoining good, forbidding evil, a protection for your iman. It protects it. If you don't do it, it will hit you. It's like cancer. Cancer. It will eat you. The only way to protect your iman, وَإِذَلَكْ شُرَعَةِ الْهِجْرَةِ وَإِذَلَكْ هِجْرَةِ is prescribed. When your iman is in danger and you cannot change, leave. Or somewhere else. They told me I have enough time, so I'm going to take my time, inshallah. Hopefully they're not going to change their opinion, because I'm going to take my time, because the subject is important and I really would like to explain it. I hope they're not going to change the word. They told me, take your time. ما حكم الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر؟ الحكم. What is the ruling? When you ask this question, by the way, what is the ruling regarding a certain act? You're trying to figure out, is it wajib? فرض? Mandatory? Is it recommended? مندوب يعني واجب that you have to do it and you're sinful if you don't. Recommended, that means if you do it you get rewarded, if you do not do it you're not punished, no sin on you. Three, is it mubah, permissible, whatever you feel like, it's okay. Is it makruh, is it disliked? Is it haram to do it? So when you ask, ما حكم الشيء, what is the ruling? What is the ruling regarding enjoining good and forbidding evil? Do we have a choice? Is it optional? Is it permissible? Is it halal? Or do we have to do it? The answer to the question is, Al-amru bil-ma'ruf wajib ala darajat. It is mandatory. But levels. I'll explain in a minute. Let me give you the dalil. Normally, if a person who claims to be faqih, someone who tells you this is wajib, this is haram, this is halal, he must provide that evidence. What is the evidence that al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy an al-munkar is mandatory? In the Quran, يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. ولتكن هذا خبر في صيغة الأمر. Let be amongst you a group who enjoy what is good, forbid what is evil, call people to the حق, call people to the خير, the goodness. هذا دليل. The second evidence which explains the issue of the levels, قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي أخرجها مسلم, حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه, and we all know the hadith, من رأى منكم منكرا فليغير. Whosoever amongst you sees evil, he must change. Then the Prophet mentioned the levels, which I referred to a minute ago. Biyadi, his hand. طيب, what if he he uses his hand, if he uses or she uses her hand, if he uses his hand, this will bring upon him darr, harm, or it will cause a greater evil. It's not going to work. On this subject, the ikhwah is very problematic. Requires a lot of guilt. That is why, by the way, the title is Enjoining Good with Good, Forbidding Evil without Evil. Because sometimes you may try to enjoin good without good. And you forbid evil and you cause it to be a greater evil. But sometimes he cannot use the hand. Then the Sharia تقول لك في الإسلام فإن لم يستطع, if you cannot, then what? Speak about it. Speak about the issue. Sometimes also speaking may get you in trouble. Or if you speak right now, the person may not listen. He may fight you. Then what you have to do? You retreat to the final and only resort, and there is no resort after this one. فَإِن لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ. Then comes in your heart. And the word of Hadith, Hadith ibn Mas'ud and the Muslim, وَلَيْسَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ مِنْ إِيمَانٍ. If you do not change that evil with your heart, what does it mean to change it with your heart? You reject it in your heart. Man, this is hard. This is dirt. In your heart, I don't like this. I just don't like it. This is death. The blood pours out. Pours. Your veins, your face turns red. Man, I don't like this. I don't want you. But I cannot use my hands. I cannot use my tongue. Your heart. But with this one comes another barrier. You have to go. You have to leave. You cannot say, I'm enjoining good, forbidding evil with my heart, and you're mixing with them. لا شوف حديث ابن مسعود في سنن ابي داود قال صلى الله عليه وسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says ان اول ما دخل من النقص على بني اسرائيل the first sign of wickedness which emerged into بني اسرائيل ان الرجل يلقى الرجل. A man would meet a man and he would see him doing evil. Yeah, man, oh so and so. This is haram. Do not do this. This is not good. Do not do this. And then at night, he goes and he eats and he drinks with him. You see, we may think that using the heart is easy. Actually, it's more difficult. I'd rather stay with those people and speak, give you down. But if you retreat to the heart, that means he cannot be with them. You have to separate. وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ فلا تقعدوا معهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره إنكم إذا مثلهم إن الله جامع الكافرين والمنافقين. هم كفروا الكفر في جهنم الجنة. أنت تنافق وأنت لو قعدت معاه if you sit with him خلاص you're approving it. You're telling him it's okay. فالحديث يبين لدي أخوة في مشكلة يعني you probably read سورة البقرة. Why in the world the children of Israel as soon as they left Egypt اليهود يعني when سيدنا موسى عليه السلام took them out of Egypt يا الله they just saw Allah سبحانه وتعالى turning the sea into a bridge. ما هو when they approached the Red Sea, the Pharaoh and his gang followed Bani Israel. وأتبعهم فرعون وجنوده بغيا وعدلا. قالوا يا موسى إنا لمدركون. هو موسى ورماهم. يقول لك يلا. قال كلا. And they saw رب العالمين وإذ نجيناهم من آل فرعون وإذ فرقنا بهم البحر فأنجيناهم وأغرقنا آل فرعون وأنتم تنظرون. Why as soon as they passed the sea وجاوزنا بني إسرائيل البحر فأتوا على قوم يعكفون على أصنام لهم قالوا يا موسى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة. يا الله as soon as they crossed to Sinai they found a group of Bedouin in the desert worshiping idols. They said موسى can we please have an idol please can we please have an idol like them. It's like the Muslims now Sheikh can I have a Christmas tree Sheikh please can I have a Christmas tree at home Sheikh can I have an idol like them. Why? Do you know why? Because those people all the life they saw the Egyptians building idols, build you know the Egyptians? They were good with building stuff, you know, idols, Ramses the second, Ramses the third. They were brought up in a culture of idols. Their hearts, because they were living in the middle of this culture, their hearts saw it normal. It's okay. It's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. A culture of influence. Because they were nourished, brought up in that culture. For them, I tell you a personal experience. I used to live in Bergen before I moved to Denver. So where I used to live, I used to pass by a Catholic church. And they have an icon of Maryam right in front of the church. Yani, an idol that represents Maryam. So I was driving one day, the first day, and I looked at my right and I saw somebody going and kneeling. Raka. Wallahi, I couldn't be. Of course, there's nothing I can do with it. I have to be careful with it. But my heart rejected it. My heart didn't like it. You know what? The following day, I'm driving, and I looked again. Not like yesterday. Then, a month later, was normal. The heart already is used to it. Well, that's the problem. If you stay in the area of evil, your heart will be used to it. You're not going to see evil anymore. ضرب القلب. لم يسمى ضرب القلب. Your heart sucked that fitness. You don't see it bad anymore. And why did Allah say فَاجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجْسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ. Stay away from any weapon. Why we're not supposed to be in the vicinity? details, okay? Don't take it as a ruling. But we're not supposed to attempt the new rules of non-Muslims. Why? Because right then he's going to do in the name of this, in the name of that, and he's watching. It's normal. I know our young children cannot do anything about this in America because that's the public school. One of the parents came to me one day and said, "Shit, my son came to me one day and then he got a little bit mad and he said, 'Geez, my son said, geez.'" He called him Jesus. Why? Because he's in the environment. It's normal. Supposed to call upon Allah. It's normal. So look, the hand, the tongue of your ministry. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I should explain that I'm talking about Muslims with one another. If we are talking about Christian and Jews, because I want to make this disclaimer before I carry on talking. Listen, once it comes to Muslims and Jews, we have a principle which we follow, which is the first thing we have to convey to them. Is La ilaha illallah. Tawheed. Ya Mu'ad, O Mu'ad, innaka ta'ti qawman ahla kitab. You're coming to the people of the book, Christian and Jew. Let me, the first thing you call them to is La ilaha illallah. So my subject today is about Muslims, with Muslims. So don't go now outside the door and go to the Christian and kill him and don't drink alcohol, don't commit adultery, you cannot go to the club. No. Hey, wait a minute. Tawheed first. Mahu, liyakul, awwal ma tad'uhum ilayh, la ilaha illallah. If they are living in a Muslim country where the majority are Muslims, that's different. That's different. But I'm talking about us living in the West. You cannot go to a Christian and tell him you cannot drink. And then you say, "Well, I'm enjoining good, I'm committing evil." You cannot tell him you cannot have a girlfriend because I'm enjoying that. No. That's not what I'm talking about. Let me clarify this before I carry on talking. I'm talking about Muslims. The subject is for Muslims. Yes, we enjoy good for the evil of non-Muslims by conveying Tawheed first. Then we speak to them about the branches. Are we doing good so far? Assalamu alaikum. Are you doing okay? I really would like to understand this subject tonight. طيب. We said that enjoining good and forbidding evil is mandatory upon you, at least with the final result, which is what? The heart. طيب. What about the Muslims? Are they doing this? Are the Muslims enjoining good and forbidding evil? You find out that the Muslims, إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي, always that exception. Wallahi, there are some who are doing it. بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ. You will find the Muslims, once it comes to enjoying good and forbidding evil, two groups, two types, two categories. نَوْعَان, صِنْفَان. صِنْف, the first time, they abandon the whole thing. They don't even do it. And they, when you ask them why, brother, why, sister, they use misconceptions. They go like, it's personal. Why do you want to interfere with the personal life of another person? Yeah, and if you go, like, it's a personal thing. يعني ولا تقول that the prophets and the messengers came to interfere with our personal lives. أنت صديق إذا you say this. Come on. لا يا شيخ لا إكراه في الدين لا إكراه في الدين يا عم لا إكراه في الدين like I said this apply to a Christian and a Jew. That you show them Islam and they reject it, خلاص I cannot force you. My job is to present Islam to you in the best manner possible. If you say no, خلاص لكن المسلم تقول لك راح الدين تقول لك راح الدين. The Muslim يحصل الله